Well, hello. It's May 8th. Friday! Hooray, hooray, hooray. Especially this Friday. Oh, never has there been a sweeter Friday. Here's why. And also, this is an easy way to completely forget about COVID-19. Whether you think it's real or you're pissed off because you think it's a damn conspiracy and coup being ran on us. My sandwich camp, I'm in. Doesn't matter. If you want to forget about it either way, this is what you do. First, you get told yesterday you need to come to work an hour earlier than normal today. Yeah, at 7, which is when I usually wake up. Because I usually start work at 8. That's cool. Because here's the situation. This spring, we have seen an incredible increase in demand for landscaping products. An incredible increase in demand. It's crazy. Somehow, I have to, kind of connect the dots. It's just crazy to me that during this economic crash, which has deliberately been brought on by governments, I feel like, but whatever. Doesn't matter. Because during it, the COVID-19. Yes. Everybody's been worried about it one way or another. But it's had interesting effects. 33 million people have lost their jobs. Oh my gosh, that's terrible. And a tragedy and the biggest scandal of all this. But somehow, since the situation and my job I'm in, just really lined up in my favor, everybody's home. Pissed, ice, quarantined. They're like, well, damn it, I'm gonna make a beautiful garden and yard. That's where we come in. And we remain essential for this reason. And people are buying so much that the reason I had to go in early today is because we had orders that had to be filled today. The product had to be made because we have sold so much. We had to get back up to where we're ahead. So usually we have a robot machine, a big machine. It's not a robot, but it is like one. It stacks the pallets for you and lines them up perfect. And it's this crazy mechanism. It's so cool. I'm not even sad that the job of stacking bags as they come off the conveyor belt has been automated away, because it's when you do it as a person. And we had to use the robot arm and people arms. So as simple as that, we had to have double time going, but the robot can really outdo us. It's just a bit of electricity and perfect pallet fast. Go robot, take it, take the job, it's yours. Cause we had to have more than just the robot could give us. We had to have every extra bit we could get. And so, oh man, when you have to do it as a person, you're just constantly, every time you put a bag on there, and then there's times I had to stomp it, times I had to wrap it, times I had to throw it on there. Every time it's using caloric in calories, man. Food. You got it. Food has to be eaten. Or your body must consume a part of itself. That's all there is to it. I was sweating gallons. It was so hot. It was so incredibly hot. I got so tired. told you I forgot about, this made me forget about COVID until I thought, ooh, COVID. And I was like, and the boss of the whole company was there, the owner. And it was cool. He was down working with us, helping out the people, helping out his company with his own hands. That's why it's so cool. That's why it's such a cool company. That's why it's a cool industry. And he was down with us working hard. Not, and it, the robot was doing its thing, and it, people had to be running that too. But he was with us. And that's how he started doing the hard work. And then he worked his way all the way up, and he owns the place. It's so cool. And, he, and so, you know, but anyways, at one point I was so tired, I was just like, hey man, Byron, I think I have COVID-19. I'm putting everybody at risk. I gotta go. He's like, you'll sweat it out, man. Because he knew. I was just trying to take advantage of them. They say never let a good crisis go to waste. You know, they say that. They say that. I'm joking, but you know. And I was joking then. But that's what I mean is, you know, work hard at something. Because what is going on is a travesty and a fiasco in the world. But the only way we can make it better is if enough people like outmatch it with a better way and just kind of ignore it. You kind of just gotta ignore it and just do your own way. What are they? It's not against the law. I mean, all you gotta say, if they ever came and talked to you and you're outside and stuff, be like, I don't have phone, news, anything. Are we not allowed to be outside? And they'd be like, you haven't heard? I'd be like, no. Well, no, we're not. And you just be like, oh, okay, I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. I had no idea. Because if you didn't, that's what it would be like. If nobody knew about COVID-19, everything would be a lot better. It is the knowing about it that is causing all the problems, and the way of knowing about it, it's fear. That's the problem. Like Franklin Delano Roosevelt said, the only thing we have to fear is fear itself. And this is why, because it can cripple you. So just release your fear. What's the worst thing that's gonna happen? Your fears are gonna come true? Well, maybe that would have happened anyway. Did having the fear lighten the experience of it happening to you? What I mean is it's just useless to fear if it becomes crippling. And a lot of the people I think that have gone to the hospital went because they became afraid of COVID. Not because they actually would have otherwise. And that's an important distinction. Just ask yourself, would I have gone to the hospital otherwise if I hadn't heard about this thing? If the answer is no, well, you know, just ask yourself what that means to you. Anyways, Friday night, weekend, I'm gonna go chill. Thank you for watching. Peace.